let us learn extraction of metals which are in the middle reactivity series. Which are the metals which come under middle reactivity series? Yes, it is zinc, iron, lead and copper. These are the metals which come under middle reactivity series. These metals which come under in the middle reactivity series, they are usually present as carbonate ore or sulfide ore. The metals which come in zinc, iron, copper and lead. These are all moderately reactive. They are moderately reactive. They are moderately reactive and the ores of these metals are usually present as sulfide ore or carbonate ore. They are present as sulfide ore or carbonate ore. If it is sulfide or carbonate ore, what should be done? We know very well, we have learned it. If it is sulfide ore, what will happen? Then what should be done? We have to subject it to roasting. Sulfide ore is subjected to roasting. You know what is roasting, right? Roasting means what? Heating the ore to a very high temperature below its melting point in the presence of oxygen or in excess of air. Okay, so it will be subjected to roasting. And what about the carbonate ore? If it is a carbonate ore, it will be subjected to calcination. By now, you know the difference between roasting and calcination, right? So both the roasting and calcination, here the ores are heated strongly, right? To a very high temperature below its melting point. Roasting is done in the presence of oxygen and calcination is done in the absence of oxygen or with a limited supply of air. So that is about roasting and calcination. After roasting and calcination, what happens? What do we get? After calcination and roasting, we get metal oxide. Metal oxide, whichever ore we are taken, so we get the oxide of the metal. After that, what should be done? It should be, the metal oxide should be subjected to reduction reaction. It should be subjected to reduction reaction that using a suitable reducing agent. Using suitable reducing agent, the metal oxide will be subjected to reduction reaction and from that metals are isolated. Metals are isolated. Okay. I hope you understood how it is done for the metals which are in the middle reactivity series. Now let us see the example for extracting of metals which are in the middle reactivity series. So let us take zinc sulfide as it is sulfate ore. So what should be done? It should be roasted. When it is roasted means oxygen is present, right? So when it is roasted and it is like it is heated to very high temperature below its melting point, roasting, so oxygen is there. Then what is obtained? We get zinc oxide. We get zinc oxide. Roasting will get you the metal oxide, that is zinc oxide, and sulfur dioxide gas will be released. Okay, so this is roasting. Okay, so let us balance this reaction. Okay, this is balance equation. After zinc oxide, what should be done? After we got the metal oxide. So after roasting, we got the metal oxide. So what should be done next? the metal oxide should be subjected to reduction reaction. Okay, it should be subjected to reduction reaction. You know what is reduction reaction? Remember oxidation and reduction reaction. Oxidation means what? It is the addition of oxygen. Oxidation is addition of oxygen, or we say removal of hydrogen. Addition of oxygen in a reaction. Okay, if an element gains oxygen, we say it is oxidation reaction. Or if hydrogen is removed, removal of hydrogen is called oxidation reaction. So what is reduction reaction? So oxidation you have understood. So what is reduction? Reduction means addition of hydrogen and removal of oxygen. That is reduction reaction. Okay, right? So this is oxidation reduction. You have learned it in previous classes. Now oxygen is there in zinc, right? So we have to use a suitable reducing agent. So we have to use a suitable reducing agent. So here we use coke. Here the reducing agent which is used is coke. Coke is the reducing agent. It is the reducing agent, right? So coke, what is coke? Coke is nothing but allotropic form of carbon. It is a allotropic form of carbon. So what is allotropy? You know, right? So allotropy you have learnt it. In 7th standard, you have learnt what is allotropy. Allotropy is the property of an element to exist in different physical form, but it has same chemical property. So which are the allotropic forms of carbon? Diamond, coke, graphite, coal, charcoal, all is a allotropic form of carbon. So when we say they use coke, coke is nothing but carbon. So carbon is used as a reducing agent. So it is subjected to reduction reaction. So using a suitable reducing agent, so it is carbon, or you can say coke. Now what happens? The carbon gets oxidized. Carbon gets oxidized. What is oxidation? It is addition of or gaining of oxygen. It's called oxidation. Now carbon will gain oxygen and it will become carbon monoxide, and we obtain zinc. Okay, we obtain zinc. This is gas and carbon, CO. It is not CO2, it is CO. CO is what? CO is carbon monoxide. Okay, so this is how we obtain the metals which are in the middle reactivity series. Okay, so here I have given you an example for roasting. Let us see for carbonate ore. So let us take zinc carbonate. So when it is carbonate ore, what should be done? Calcination. Okay, so if we are subjecting the carbonate ore to calcination, calcination means what? You are heating the ore in the absence of oxygen or in limited supply of air. So you are heating it, so you get zinc oxide and carbon dioxide gas will be liberated. Okay, so we got zinc oxide. Further, what we have to do? It has to subject it to reduction reaction using a suitable reducing agent. So here again the coke is only used, okay, and we get zinc separated from its carbonate ore. Okay, so which is the reducing agent here? Carbon is reducing agent. As carbon is getting oxidized, so it is a reducing agent. Okay, as carbon is getting oxidized, that is, it is gaining carbon oxygen, so it is a reducing agent. Always remember like this: the one which is getting oxidized will be a reducing agent. Now, zinc is getting reduced. Why it is getting reduced? Because in zinc oxide is getting reduced. How it is getting reduced? Because it is losing oxygen. As it is getting reduced, so zinc oxide will be the oxidizing agent. I hope this is clear for you. Now we understood how we get the metal from its sulfide ore as well as carbonate ore. Now let us see whether always carbon is used as a reducing agent. No, carbon need not be always used as a reducing agent. Besides carbon, they can use metals which are of high reactivity series. Okay, how they can use the metals which are in high reactivity series? The reason is that these metals which are high reactive metal, they can displace the metals which come under the lower activity series. That is, they can use sodium, calcium, magnesium as well as aluminium. These are all reactive element, right? These are highly reactive metal. They are highly reactive metals, right? These can be used as reducing agent. Now, how can they use this as a reducing agent? Is because as they are reactive, if in a compound there is a metal which is of lower activity series, so they can displace. These metals can displace the metal which is of lower activity, okay, lower activity series. Okay, so these can displace the metal which is of lower activity from its compound. Okay, so let me take one example, then you'll understand. So let us take the example of manganese oxide. Manganese oxide, that is MnO2. So let us take manganese oxide. Okay, for this, to displace manganese from manganese oxide, we can take aluminium. Aluminium is more reactive than manganese. So what it will do? It can displace manganese from manganese oxide and it can form aluminium oxide. Okay, so manganese will be displaced and we get aluminium oxide. See, here aluminium is acting as a reducing agent. So you know what is reducing agent? An element or a metal which gets oxidized. See, aluminium does not have oxygen and here it is gaining oxygen. Gaining of oxygen is called oxidation. As it is gaining oxygen, so it is a reducing agent. Okay, aluminium is reducing agent. So what this will do? Aluminium will displace manganese from manganese oxide and we get manganese. Okay, so let us balance the reaction. Okay. So this is balanced equation. Okay, so here 3MnO2 plus OAl gives you 3Mn plus 2Al2O3. Al2O3 is aluminium oxide. Now, this reaction is a highly exothermic reaction. It is a exothermic reaction. What is exothermic reaction means? A reaction in which a lot of heat is generated. So here a lot of heat will be generated and the manganese which is obtained will be a molten form. It will be in liquid form or molten form. That much of heat is created. So this is a exothermic reaction. Not only this, as it is a highly exothermic reaction, this has a use actually. This finds a use in case of machines which will develop crack, the parts of machines which will develop a crack, or if they want to join the railway tracks, right? So they want these metals to be in molten state and they use a process called thermit process. So what is this thermit process? So let us see what is thermit process. So thermit process, they use mixture of iron oxide with aluminium. Okay, it's a mixture. Thermit is a mixture. Thermit is a mixture of iron oxide, or we say ferric oxide, iron oxide and aluminium. It's a mixture. So what is mixture of iron oxide and aluminium is called thermit. So where this thermit used? The thermit or the thermit process is used for sealing the cracks in any machinery part. Okay, any machinery part, if they want to seal the crack. Not only that, it is also used for joining the railway tracks. The railway tracks. So what they do is, they take the mixture, that is thermit mixture. What is thermit mixture? It is a iron oxide and aluminium in a crucible. In a crucible. Crucible means what? A crucible is something which can withstand a high heat. So it will be made up of silica. Okay. So they take the mixture, the thermit mixture. Thermit mixture is what? So this is crucible. Thermit mixture is what? Iron oxide plus aluminium. Right? So they will be heated. So when they are heated, what will happen? So they will undergo a displacement reaction. And I told you, as this is an exothermic reaction, the iron will be obtained. Iron which is obtained will be in molten form. So there will be one small vent will be given. Opening is there. So if this is the part which is cracked. Imagine this is the part which is cracked, okay? So they heat it and the molten iron will be passed through this vent, okay? And this will seal the crack, okay? So this is what thermit process is about. So let us write down the equation for this. So iron oxide, that is Fe2O3 plus aluminium Al. So you get iron plus aluminium oxide, a lot of heat is generated and the iron which is obtained will be in liquid form. So let us balance the equation. Okay, so it is balanced. So this is about Thermit reaction. I hope you understood how they obtain the metals which are in the middle reactivity series. Now let us see how we can extract the metal which is in the high reactivity series.